Brothers are Eugene,
yes, sir.
And Phantasm, yes, the Tall Man.
Yes, sir.
Now, you thought I forgot that, huh?
Yeah.
I do my homework, sir. I know you, bro. You're my brother. So I'll never forget that. How's everybody doing?
Everybody's good, man.
Good, Wiz?
Fabulous, you know.
Can you lift your mic up?
Yeah, we're good, right? Here. Can you hear me?
I got you.
All right.
Yeah.
You jizzle.
I got a story to tell.
I got a basketball story too. What you was talking about?
Crazy. I
couldn't get a bunch of memorabilia, but I did get the latest thing you did.
Perfect.
Yes, you know what I'm saying? I was looking for stuff for you, but I couldn't find anything.
I ain't got nothing, man. My man's doing it all, man. He's not my Adams, he's doing anything.
I said, where's Phantasm?
I'm gonna wear a shirt with your picture on it.
Yo, listen, don't let him do big too.
I saw him rhyming on Instagram. I said,
Johnson. Because he ain't fucking Johnson.
But real quick, I want to get to you, Nick. So, people, pay attention. All right? Pay close attention. Cut the beat off. You got Wiz.
Nick Wiz.
I just got to do an introduction, so you got to cut the beat off. So.
Great.
Cut the beat off. Nick Wiz, the great. Fantastic. Good brother, good soul. I like to have everybody with good energy at the show with me an hour. So, Wiz, you've been doing music for how many years?
Since 90.
90.
Yeah, man. It started off with dancing, but...
You was a break dancer?
Yeah, man, I used to do a little something, you know. I was like, you know what? Let me start dipping and dabbing in this beat making thing, you know. And you know, I like digging through the records and listening to stuff, man. So
did you go to school for it?
Absolutely not.
That's what I love about my show, because everybody that comes up here never went to school for the crap that they have and making thousands, millions off of it, and never went to school for it.
It's crazy.
So the broad commercials and all that dumb shit is
on the job training.
Yeah. So you dug in the crates.
Yeah, man. Made some whack beats. You know, that's how it all starts.
You do that,
and then eventually you get into where you need to be. You know, so especially getting critiqued by guys like Kid Capri, man. Back in the days, you know, we was going up to the radio station and straight told my man that I was working with. He was like, "Yo, man, you need to lose that kid making those beats, man." And I sat there like all sad, man. Like
I'm out of here.
I was messed up because, he was around Drez and all these other rappers I looked up to.
Yeah.
So I'm sitting there thinking, I'm like, all right. Instead of taking it the way, I was upset that day, man. But after that, man, I started polishing up everything and just.
But that's some things you need, like a major
need. If it wasn't for that, man, I'm going to be honest with you, bro. It'd have been some.
Yeah.
I'd have been still making.
Right. Bullshit.
Hit the loop. And that's it, man. You know what I'm saying? So, Casio keyboard.
Hey, Brooklyn guy, criminal. He made me nervous. Let's say that to my camera. So you started, and then how did you get hooked up with the record labels?
I was working with Ant and Danny.
Mm-hmm.
Actually, Lyricist Lounge.
Okay.
And that's how I got to these gentlemen here.
Underground Kings.
You know, because they were working, actually, Ant and Danny were working on something themselves, and then they just put it to the side. I was like, hey, Wiz, we want to bring down the group Dwellers.
Mm-hmm.
I was like, all right. I said, yeah, whatever, man. Let's do what we got to do. And, I wound up recording the guys, doing the demo, putting it together for Loud, and they got a deal, man. And in between all that, I was slipping in beats here and there until finally they liked one.
He never left that basement yet. Bro, that's right.
It's a fact. That's a fact.
So you started the beats. Besides the Dwellers, whatever artists have you worked with, have you ever went?
Well, I'll tell you what. Dwellers sparked it, got me to Rakim,
mm-hmm.
Mad Skills, Chubb Rock. I mean, man, dude.
The list goes on.
Chino XL, Be Real, Shauna. I mean, it's like a list of artists I got to work with, so.
So with any of the artists that you work with, you have... Plaques, no plaques,
I got a plaque for Rakim, the 18th letter.
Wow. I didn't know you did that. See, my
whole book
is
old. I was on there. It's crazy, man. I mean, it's great. It looks nice.
It
collects dust.
Like Mike Tyson said.
The only thing that don't collect dust is money, man.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying? So, and I mean, it's nice, man. It's definitely, you know, a nice piece of jewelry on the wall. Yeah, it's wall jewelry, man.
So you out of the music, you're not out of the music, but now you're doing music for movies.
Well, yeah, I'm still, yeah, so I'm in the music, but I'm not where, you know, you're reading the credits on albums that are coming out. Basically, it's, you know, TV, film, commercials.
Yeah.
You know, when you don't open up the flyers and, you know, the little the brochure, see, hey, man, produced by who did this? You know, it ain't that. So, yeah. But it makes sense when it comes to the royalties and the checks that are cut behind it, you know. So, you know, it's just evolution, man.
Yeah.
And I'm doing all kinds of music.
That's what I say, so, evolution all day. You have an evolution. If you're not going up, what are you doing? You're wasting your time. And people get mad when I say that, but it's the truth. It's like, you're sitting there doing what, you know?
Trying to keep it real, you know? I mean, well, that's cool. That's nice.
That's nice.
Keep on keeping it real.
Come going over here.
I'm going to go work on some other stuff here, man. This is getting a little boring for me, man. Yeah. You know, so, you know.
So, if you can, just give, could you give us a couple of movies that you worked on?
I'm going to tell you the newest thing I worked on. It's a Michael Jordan documentary called Unbanned.
Wow.
And I did a nice chunk of the music along with a bunch of other guys, but that's like the biggest thing right now, which they're locking in some situations, you know, but that was something else, man. Yeah. Just the knowledge that I got from working on it, just watching the footage and putting music to it, man. It's crazy, man. Yeah. I mean, you know, done stuff at Disney.
Tell some of the Disney ones for the mothers out there that got kids and they want to listen to
you. You know what? I actually did a commercial for one of their roller coasters. You know,
Disney roller coasters?
Yeah. Wow. So Seven Dwarf Mine Train. We did the music for that. Just landed a Spectrum commercial.
Wow.
And then my music's in Love and Hip Hop, man. It's just NASCAR. It's crazy. So.
Yeah.
It's all over the place, man.
I love it. When you keep working, I love it.
Yeah, man.
Phantasm.
Yes, sir.
What you been up to, brother?
Same old thing, man.
Same old thing?
Nothing gonna change for me, man.
It got to change, but we just talking about the evolution, sir.
Same grind, same hustle.
So you still doing music?
Yeah, a little bit.
A little bit?
Mm-hmm.
Are you trying to, you know, you going the beat way too, or?
I'm trying to get, like these guys, man. These guys make phenomenal beats, man. So I'm trying to get my beat made.
You jizzle. Stop sipping on the yak.
Yeah, this is one I don't think
you spoke to Jesus today.
Yeah,
tap that.
Liquor had me someplace else. My wine is more.
Yeah, come on.
Yeah. I'm trying to wean off that too, but it's cold.
Turn up the lights.
Yeah,
roll see-through shit.
Yeah, man.
I know you do.
Slippers on like this. I'm a ghost-face killer roll. Sorry.
So, any new music? Anything going on?
We put out Portals.
Portals, we got Portals.
Still rocking.
Same Portals.
Still rocking. I'm doing beats now also. I did a joint for Method, Swae, Seva, G-Rap, and Joe Pesci.
Wow.
Who else I got? I did this remix joint that me, Sean Price, and such. I did joints with DBS. So I'm working, man. A lot of overseas artists. I just opened up a dope beat page, and I'm trying to just whizzle my way into the TV commercials and stuff like that. So this year is gonna be exciting, man. And then, you know, hopefully, me and my man try to do something or maybe put something else out. But as for now, we got some shows coming up. We about to go back overseas. So
nice.
It's good, man. And then I got an inspirational project coming out too.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So we working, man.
That's actually the dope thing, because like I see a lot of, I don't know, do you guys like being called old school? Because a lot of guys that came up said they didn't like
being called. I like being called Thomas artists. We Thomas, man.
Yeah. So
no matter where you put us, we gonna eat.
We got the Thomas artists that come up. Like we had a couple of people come up, Daz FX and CL Smooth was to come up in a couple of weeks. And, you know, all of them is touring now. And I know that a lot of the 90s artists are touring now. Like, there's a big demand for you guys. Yeah, like a lot of OC don't want to hear these young guys. They're like, man, for you to come over there. So you guys are, like, trying to get in that.
Yeah, now we could get in it. Mm-hmm. I mean, it's just now we just got to merge together and start just creating that traffic.
Yeah.
It's easy, man.
Yeah.
It's easy. I mean, and you know, connecting with Nick Wiz. This is a tour right here.
Yeah,
I'll be honest with you.
Nick, so do Nick, you know.
He came out with us. Nick was with us. He was overseas with us, bro.
Do Nick grab your your coattail. And you know, for Viz, did you reach out to Nick when you first started, or did you just did your own thing?
Wiz be ducking in, man. He's on his case all the time.
About what? What? He talking about making beats. He talking about making beats, right?
Yeah.
You know, this guy right here. No, not me. Yo, this dude right here.
I promise you, Wiz always, he always makes shots. He always got something in pocket. You know what I mean? So that ain't never gonna change. It's different with Wiz than us rocking with other producers, because he's actually family, like, for real.
Yeah,
like,
first,
when
definitely.
We first came up in the game, it was like we got connected and ever since then. You know what I mean?
I remember when you was first, when we first working on the album, and I got to New Jersey.
Yeah.
We didn't really talk that much when I first met you, because you was kind of like, oh, let's get you done.
Yeah.
I was like, hey, buddy.
He was like, listen, the rhythm's about that business.
Yeah, that's it. As soon as he came in, he was like, yeah, you better go. I was like, hey. He was like, yeah, fuck you, sit down. So that's how me and King, that's how we met. He was kind of like, sit down, we got work to do.
And that's the thing that made it all, it made it work.
Mm-hmm.
Because he wasn't scared to say, ah, bro, you got to go back in.
Yeah.
You got to go back in.
Yeah.
You sound right. Like, I'm not going to come out of there.
Yeah.
Wow, you sound right. And even in the beat situation, like me and Finn trying to get into the beat game, like you could call him any time of the night. I promise you, I called Wiz one time when I first got my drum machine, like 50 times back to back, and his attitude was the same. Nah, bro, I'm fired up, and we're going to walk through. It wasn't like, yo. Come on, man, you record. I'm fired up. I mean, that's why I love Wiz, man. He's in pocket, man. That's my bro, man. You know what I'm saying? That's our family, for real.
We love Nick, man.
So,
man, so now this question that I always ask everybody, I didn't get to ask Wavy, because he kind of creeped off. I didn't look like he wanted to answer the question. But I think everybody in this whole circle we have here is married.
Everybody. Well, yeah.
Yeah, everybody.
Yes, sir.
So I make the edge was a C.
Wait, well, let me just say this. I'm married, bro. And direct.
Hold on.
Married. 13 years.
Ooh, that's a
beautiful thing.
Nick, I know you've been married. You've been married. Tall man.
I'm on that.
And Outlaw, my man, Outlaw.
Hell yeah, married people. Stand up.
I said we make it DC 47.
The crazy part is, not that I'm against it, he is off again.
Hold on. Before I don't mean to cut you in. When I hear somebody say the crazy part about it, I'm getting ready for something. So go ahead, shoot.
Well, I'm not saying I'm against it. We talked about this on my last show. If anybody listened to the last show, I'm a weirdo. So I'm learning to get over my weirdo shit before I bring that to somebody else.
That makes sense.
So it's not that I don't want to be. And you know.
Eugene,
what are you laughing at, sir?
Speaking of weirdo. Yo, let me tell you something, too. That's my brother. That's my little brother. We've been through a lot. Can I tell him the story?
Tell the story. You got to tell him the story.
Hold on.
Once you said weirdo, that was a segue for me to go into it.
Yeah, we know.
Yo. Bro gives me a call. This is years ago before we was married.
Yeah, all this before we married.
All this before we married.
Yeah.
I get a call from him, yo, I got these two things with me. What you doing?
I'm like,
I said, what you mean? If you co-sign this money, let's go. So we go to the famous Oasis Hotel in Pennsylvania.
That's what the cover deal is going on. There's two keys over there.
So
he gets up in there, so he's in there before me. He was in there. He got this bra. Now his bra, she's smoking. This is the tip one for the team.
She wasn't that bad.
Now my chick, she wasn't that bad.
Yeah.
But her get up was so crazy.
It was crazy.
She had on like this buzzy, like the sweater with the fur was all around her neck, so crazy. Now her face was all, she had a fatty, that's what brought me. Yeah. A couple of drinks, I was looking at the fatty the whole night.
You know that.
Man, I got that shorty in the room. She took her stuff off, man. Yo, she smelled like a box of warm pumps.
Let's call them right away. Yo, bro,
what we doing? Hurry up.
Let's go.
You know what? I'll wait for you downstairs.
Hey, yo, we got mad story.
Yo.
Hey, you got one downstairs waiting with a buzzer too. We got there.
She was mad as a what? She was pissed. I said, never again, bro. Yo. I'm not taking nothing for the team. No,
yo, we got some. We used to, like, during the 90s, I used to have, you know, my crib, condo and Brownsville was party. Yeah. Oh, my God. We had strippers, midgets, lights. I called everybody up. I'm like, yo, this one, no, we are. We're just really doing that. Right now, I'm going out. I have food. Bitches are serving chicken and thongs. It's crazy.
They had chicken on their, in their thongs, feeding chicken. They were feeding chicken through their thongs. It was crazy. They had a lot of fun.
You, he took one for the team, and I took one for the team. Seriously, hardcore took one. That was fan support, too.
Yes.
When Shorty passed away.
Yes, sir.
You made her pass away.
Yes.
You made her pass away. My man. I think you left me. She died of heart stop. Jump off, bro. I used to throw, cut parties, so we used to have all types of girls. So my girl, well, she wasn't my girl, but the girl that wanted to be with me was the oldest girl in the room. You wasn't in high school no more. I was like, what are you even doing here? So she'd always be like, oh, you know, and I'm like, no, I'm not having sex with you. Get out of here. Uh-huh. And the crazy part is the production of that is standing behind y'all because of Phantasm. Uh-huh. So that's my son right there. So Phantasm, so like, she's the oldest person in the building. So they was like, oh. So they said, if you don't have sex with her, all the girls are going to leave because she's cool with all the girls. So Phantom was like, yo.
I'm like, it's my party. I'm the host. Like, I got to have sex. Y'all, this is what y'all do.
Gotta do.
Phantom goes, bro, the girl's going to leave.
Bro, you got to take one for the team.
Now, all the girls, they're looking with their pocket, their little bags, like,
yeah,
we out. And I was like, man.
Gotta take that one. Yeah.
And I did it, and 23 years later, boom.
Hey, you got
it. Yeah, so. The best thing that came out of that was him. That's my dog. I raised him since he came out of that. That muffin hole and shit. This is a good segue to say that is a bunch of good men here that take care of their kids.
And willing to take one for the team.
And willing to take one for the team.
My name's Frankie Johnson.
This is a show. You know what's funny? The show is supposed to be about music and coming back up. And we just all the way around.
Smokes and jokes, man.
I appreciate y'all too. I gotta say, I try to tell everybody, because I say, when I say it's friends in the room, it's family. So, Wavy, most definitely, Southern Brothers from, like I said, from 90s Wiz, and DJ Butter, I knew forever today, Brownsville. But I appreciate you guys, because not only are y'all on my show, and I'm like really excited, I'm kind of nerve shaking and shit, but. Wiz came from Jersey.
Paid
tunnels to come see me. So I'm really appreciate it.
Yeah, you anything?
Fan came from where?
Maryland.
Check this. Now listen up. Like I said, we have three. It's 3 million viewers on this. I think we got about half of that. So understand. My music off again. Understand. Maryland and Jersey. Some other people have told me to kiss my ass. You ain't paying me, I'm not doing it. Fuck out my face.
They did the phone in. Yo, I call in.
I'm
gonna say. I'm in.
And let me tell you how fake people are, and then we can go back. I went to one of my boys, I ain't gonna say my boy, but somebody I knew for just as long as I knew you, I'll tell you what I'm talking about. But, also a comedian. And I say, yo, bro, I say, I got a new show, come to my show, whatever like that. This mother said,
how much you gonna trip?
Bro, he said, I'd do it for $500.
I already know.
And I said, what type of, when niggas would choke you in the club.
Yo, I would give him a shot.
On him. When I was young, bro, Wiz, I was a different man.
Nah, man.
They was in his pockets. And I went in there, took niggas in the bathroom and said, give me what you took from him and what you got.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And then you charged me $500.
You know I know you.
You know what I'm saying?
You know what we've been doing.
You trying to keep a clean show, but
I know,
yes.
But I know you know what you're talking
about. Exactly.
And he said one time, he said something, I was like, yo, if it's back then?
Yeah.
That was back then, my credit card then? And it's an A thing.
Before 50 came with his, no. Put my fault. Mano, which is my dog too, supposed to be coming up. But Mano, before he came with the hand of God, UG had it.
Man.
You show me this.
Man, look at this.
Them shits, and it was bigger because they were swollen from slashing.
I gotta tell you, I used to slap that stripper's butt, they used to look back like we're seven people, you know? I mean,
real ripple effect. Yeah, you're an idiot. But yeah, but seriously, like, I appreciate y'all. I really appreciate y'all for the time. And I want to say something too, that black people. Wiz, are you Spanish? I never asked you that. You white?
No, I'm Greek.
Greek?
Yeah.
Like, I like how you separated. I'm not white, I'm Greek.
Nah, son, not with this.
Yeah, I'm not with them. But you know, black people are funny. Because, you know, like I said, we're booked over to March. So we got people, we got Christ coming through, we got people coming through, so it's really dope. But everybody that I sent the contract to, that's Phantasm. I called Phantasm. I said, Phantasm, could you sign the contract? He said, what is it for? So I explained, you know, when you're doing video, you know, I might use it for a drive by. I might replay it. You might say, hey, I didn't say that. You know, but he's just saying we're good, that you agreed to be in the show. So, but everybody, but not even just you, everybody is going to be like, so is that binding? No, it says it's just for you to be on the video. You signed the right way.
I kind of proofread it like twice. Yeah. You guys are my family. I changed a couple of words around, but your family's in
there. That's one sentence that you're going to be on the show, but, you know, lawyer-wise, they got to write it long like that. But so they don't understand that you're approving me to talk to you. That's all you're saying.
Hey, use our likeness.
Yeah, use your likeness. Yeah, we have video. We have video, so everybody watching.
I see your party with a couple of things. So, you know, hey, man, whatever you need from me.
And the thing that's crazy about it, that when he used to come, you know, y'all was always superstars. You know, not even before the album. So y'all was like suicide. So when they came up, girls were like, did you tell them I'm gonna have sex? I'm not telling, that's a girl he had a dick. I told you I'm gonna have sex with him. Like, what the hell?
No, I'm not gonna tell that one.
Well, no, tell the stories.
Midget, bro.
We just talked about that midget. So y'all know I'm not lying.
It's called between that best friend. It was Universal Circus.
Bro, I could not sleep. I'm in there laying in the bed like a dead crawhead. Oh, boof, boof, boof.
Yo, she was flipping on like a nigga. She was doing all kinds of tricks, like layouts. Yeah, it was crazy.
They broke my bed, broke my little pull-out couch.
Yeah, I was trying to push her through the floor, man. She was small too. I was like, man, you don't even know what you were. She was stuck between the springs. I said, yeah. Come on, yeah, mommy. Come on.
Yo, DJ Butter, do we have, you have anything lined up? Old Dwellers? Let us get a few tracks just for the young people who's listening, just so they know who we're talking to or what we're doing. You know, go.
I got that back. Didn't know I had the skills for the traffic on the track. niggas tying up your mind.